Every car has its good things and every car has its bad things. This is the Renault Megane EV60. It has 5 bad things and 5 good things. Welcome to It's Only Electric. Let's start with the first bad thing. The first bad thing is this. A power button on an EV. This is not necessary anymore. You don't need this. So every time I enter the car or exit the car, I need to turn on the ignition or turn it off. Totally waste of time. The second thing is this thing, the key fob. This looks like a key fob from the Renault Clio from 1995. This is not how it should look anymore. Number three, the region pedals. A great thing to have in this car, but the car doesn't save the amount of region you set it to on your profile. So it resets all the time, every time you enter the car. So the first thing I need to do is to maximize the region when I enter the car. Just save the region to the profile. Number two is the amount of space for your feet in the back seat. This actually takes away a lot of space in the back seat, and it's much harder to utilize the way you want. If I had just made the seats a bit slimmer or a bit higher, they would have avoided this problem. And to the last annoying and bad thing of this car is the QI charger. A QI charger needs to be placed or needs to exist in all cars. It does here, but the placing is awful. I mean, you have like 3 centimeters of space on top of the phone and no space on the sides. So this compartment here needs to be a bit lower because it's very hard to pull your phone out and put your phone in. This is actually the most annoying thing in this car. Let's jump into and look at the 5 best things with this car. The first point on the list is the regen pedals. They are great. I mean, I really miss those in my Tesla and in the ID3. It's easy to change the regen when you need to. They're nicely placed. Number 4 is this button, the drive mode selector. So if I push this, I change the drive mode. You can see it in the instrument cluster. And you have a lot of drive modes: Eco, Sport, Personal, Comfort. Very easy to change and nicely done. Number 3. The screen layout, with the 2 big 12-inch screens nicely put together in a black panel. It looks really modern and sleek, and it's not this iPad-like look as a lot of other cars have. It's more or less integrated in the car, and I like that. Number 2, this car is running Android Automotive. 12-inch screen, 12-inch screen, great navigation with Google Maps, great integration with Google Assistant. You can use Google Assistant for everything, exactly as you do at home. So greatly integrated Google Automotive. It opens up and gives you a lot of choices when it comes to software. It works good. It's quick, it's responsive, and it's evolving. Number 1. For me, this is the best looking car in the segment. It beats the Volkswagen ID3. It beats the MG4, hands down. Both when it comes to exterior looks and when it comes to interior design. It looks really good. It's a sporty look, but yet sophisticated, nicely packaged. And you see that this is a modern car, an electric car. So that's the summary of my 5 bad and 5 good things of this car. In general, a great car, but all cars has its flaws and also the good things. That's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to support my work. Thank you for watching. Speak to you soon.